With the latest chapter of Bleach, No Breath from Hell, comes a new set of possibilities that could potentially change anything and everything we know about the series. That is, if we actually get chapters. Let's not worry about that for now though. With just one single chapter, we're able to speculate what could possibly happen in future chapters. Whether or not Taite Kubo, the creator of Bleach, decides to continue this arc is a topic for another discussion. In this video, I, along with my good friend and fellow YouTuber, Makai, will talk about some of the things we are excited to see in this possible Hell arc. Oh, and spoiler alert for those of you who haven't read the new chapter. If you haven't read it yet, I suggest you do. You could also watch my video on the chapter if you don't feel like reading it. You can watch my video here. But anyways, onto the video. First on the list is a pretty obvious one considering what happened in the chapter, the return of fan favorite characters via Hell. In the chapter, we witnessed the return of Jushiro Okitake and Zyloporo mentions Unohana and Yamamoto. If the arc does continue, we will see Unohana, Yama, and Jushiro. But who else could we see? Kubo could use this opportunity to bring back Gin Ichimaru, for example. Obviously, coupled with some explanation on how he made it there would be ideal. Something else Kubo could do is to finally introduce some light novel characters into the main story. Not only would it be pretty sick to see characters like Tokinata and Azashiro, but Kubo would be directly tying the light novels into the main story, and in turn, give us things like Shuhei and Shinji's Bankai, and the return of some Quincy's that are still alive. I also feel like we'll get past Gotei 13 members. That's just inevitable in my opinion. As you may know, the Soul Society has a very complex and complicated history. Each generation of members of the Gotei 13 is built on the last. So bringing in past members of the Gotei 13 is essential in my opinion. Aside from light novel characters and former Gotei 13 members, I would love to see the return of some Arrancars and Quincy's and the role that they will have in Hell. The Konzo Resai, the ritual that inadvertently sends deceased captains to Hell, is a little flexible and may not even be required to send a powerful Soul Reaper to Hell. And there have been many Hollows and Arrancars cleansed by a Soul Reaper's blade. The possibilities are endless. On to my second wish. I said this in my Hellverse video, but I believe some of the things from the Bleach Hellverse movie should be incorporated into canon through the new Hell arc. Obviously, not everything should be brought in because it just wouldn't make sense, but there are a couple of things from this movie that I think should be in the new arc. First, sinners. To be more specific, the concept of sinners. Sinners is just a label given to those that have been cast into Hell. We technically already have them. When I say sinners, I mean characters with unique abilities gained through Hell. A good example would be Shuren and his group. Speaking of Shuren and the other sinners, I wouldn't mind seeing them make a return. Notice how every arc in Bleach takes place in a unique realm. Soul Society arc takes place in the Soul Society. A large chunk of the Arrancar arc takes place in Waco Mundo and Karakura Town. With each realm comes antagonistic groups. In the Soul Society, you had the Soul Reapers playing an antagonistic role. In Waco Mundo, Hollows and Arrancars, most notably Aizen and the Espada. If this pattern continues, I feel like a group of sinners would be pretty fitting for the arc. And if you really wanted to, you could go full on fan service. The group could consist of old and new characters, Arrancar and Soul Reaper alike. Oh, and the Guardians of Hell would be awesome to see too. They are the only thing that maintained whatever semblance of structure Hell had. The levels of Hell is also something that the Hellverse movie introduced that I would love to see in the new Hell arc. I feel that the movie handled the different layers of Hell pretty well. Each level had a unique design and presented their own obstacles for Ichigo. Every level had some environment factor that stood out and could potentially be used to turn the tide of a battle. In the movie, the third level had acid pools that did seem to hurt Garugai in his fight with Renji. The fourth level is literally a desert made of crushed bones. And while all these levels in the Hell movie are pretty cool, I wouldn't mind seeing a fresh set of levels. I just want to see levels in Hell. I just feel like that is an absolute requirement to any Hell in fiction. In the movie, Hell made Ichigo unpredictable. Ichigo struggled to keep his Hollow suppressed during his stay in Hell. At first, it was the random Hollow Mask. Later on, he fully Hollified and destroyed the Gates of Hell using a charged Sero. When he returned to save his friends, he almost fully Hollified once again. It made his fights very difficult and kinda was the main point of the whole movie. I kinda wanna see this again mainly for the fact that Ichigo has mastered his abilities. How will Hell affect him now that Ichigo has mastered it all? I would love to see how Hell treats Ichigo, even Kazui. Speaking of Kazui, we should all keep an eye on him. This is my third wish. I know people hate the notion of quote-unquote next generation stories in manga, mainly because of Boruto, but I think this is nothing to worry about at all. First of all, I doubt Kazui is going to be the protagonist of this arc. I do believe he will play an integral role in this arc, but definitely not the main character. In the latest chapter, Kazui shows off the power of manifestation and portal summoning. Near the beginning of the chapter, he creates a portal that looks almost exactly the same as the Hell portal Zyloporo comes out of. Both portals and the Gates of Hell themselves have Hell butterflies near them, and the last couple of pages show him looking up at the gate smiling. He opens up portals to hell and sends souls through it. It doesn't seem like he knows that he's sending people to hell either. I think he's just a little too innocent. I'm looking forward to some elaboration of this ability and his other manifestations. Also, his ability to become a Soul Reaper without the use of an external device like his dad. Speaking of Ichigo and Kazui, I'm also looking forward to seeing his dynamic with Ichigo. I wonder what type of kid Kazui is. Will he work well with Ichigo, or will it be more of a Boruto thing? And of course, his interaction with the Soul Reapers is something I am also looking forward to.
I am looking forward to several things in the Bleach Hell arc, though these are things that I am most excited for, with the first being the potential of Kazui and Ichika. Ichigo and Renji's kid have the capabilities of being what Toshiro is, though not a jobber, an actual force to be reckoned with. We can see the potential of these two as this arc goes on, as they could be very useful. Kazui being one of the pieces in the one shot showed that he was able to not only go into his Soul Reaper form without using a medium, he was also able to summon up a portal. He can also manifest a large fish. A fish! He's riding on energy, my guy. What if he has like a secondary ability, or his ability is something that is based off of Orihime and Ichigo? His potential is ridiculous, and Renji's kid, Ichika, while despite Renji not having some like broken abilities, her mom is Rukia. And that itself could be really crazy. She could serve as like the more powerful one, or they can go with the same parallel and have her be more like Rukia, where she's more useful with her abilities, though Renji was more of a brute and Rukia was more of the brains, as well as making usage of her powers more effectively. Having the two together makes a powerhouse, a force to be reckoned with. That's the first thing I'm looking forward to. The second thing, and this deals with characters we already know, Ichigo, Rukia, Renji, Toshiro. I want to see what they have done with their Bankais. Characters like Rukia barely was able to use her Bankai because she just unlocked it and didn't get a chance to train with it too much to know the full capabilities of it outside of a couple things. Byakuya noted it that her Bankai was still incomplete. Renji only became aware of the true Bankai that he had, and outside of like 2-3 fights, we don't see what the true capabilities of it. Though that's not as exciting. Mostly, it's Rukia, Toshiro, and Ichigo. With Toshiro having to become an adult to make usage of his Bankai as it matures, and Ichigo, we got hoed and never saw what it could actually do. The Hell arc could finally answer those questions pertaining to their Zanpakuto. A subtle point is that we saw the concept and it was never touched up on ever again in the series, and it was when Kubo had Aizen and Ichigo's swords combined to their hands. Aizen alluded to the possibility that the true form of the Zanpakuto is combining with the user in a permanent like way. Though we never got that. At the end of the series, we got Ichigo with his holification form, which could signify that was the closest to us going back to that idea. So it is perhaps that idea may want to get explored in this arc. And then another thing that I would likely want to see is Aizen having a slight role in this arc. Aizen, outside of maybe one arc, played a role in there. Soul Society arc, he basically played the secret role until they find out what he was doing. And the Arrancar arc, all throughout, apparently he planned all of Ichigo's battles. And even in the final war, if it wasn't for him, Ichigo may not have actually won, nor would the ties have turned in the favor of the Soul Reapers. So do you see, Aizen is a somewhat important character, and I think he may in fact be able to fill in some information gaps when it comes to Hell itself. Same thing could be said about Kisuke. Perhaps he might be the one to fill in the gaps when it comes to Hell and what it truly is. And then the last thing that I am looking forward to when it comes to this arc is Ichigo's next power up. Now, if you guys have been paying attention in the series, and every major arc, Ichigo gets a new power up and it becomes a bit of a meme. Ichigo got the full brain powers. Prior to that, Ichigo got Bankai. Ichigo had his final Bankai. He had all of these power ups, and we see this time and time again. So this arc shouldn't be no different. Perhaps we might see perhaps something like the clad armor that he got in the Hell movie, or something entirely new, bringing in a new structure of power. Perhaps the power that the characters are mostly comfortable using don't work in the conventional way in Hell, and it changes the rules, so even characters who are somewhat weak now become more relevant. It'd be a cool way to reintroduce characters and make them useful. Though, with that said, that's gonna end up my part. It was nice hopping on a video with Bleach Center for time's sake. But if you guys enjoyed, hey, check me out on my social medias.
What are you looking forward to in Bleach's new Hell arc? Maybe you would like to add something that was already said, or maybe you have your own ideas. Let us know down in the comment section. If you want more Makai, his Twitter link will be down in the description. Go check him out if you're looking to be enlightened. But anyways, guys, that is it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you did, please leave a comment and also like. If you didn't, dislike and leave a comment. And consider subscribing. I do a whole bunch of Bleach content. Anything Bleach related, you'll probably find it on my channel. Any Bleach data books, Bleach light novels, everything. Burn the Witch, you name it. But regardless if you're subscribed or not, I thank you and have a good one. Peace.